Even though we had a blast, that's life on my past. If it makes sense, so we can live in the present, to have a better future for our children.
To the past, present, and future show, where God is the same yesterday and today and forever. Yes, sir. I'm on the phone with my homeboy from Germany. Well, he's from Detroit. He's residing in Germany right now. What's up, my brother? Let everybody know who you are.
What's up, Rodney? My name is Derrick Alexander, everybody. Yeah, I'm from Detroit, Michigan, but everybody called me Smack back then. Yeah, I'm currently living in Ramstein, Germany.
Ramstein, Germany. I have a brother-in-law in Germany. I don't know what part he stays in. My wife's brother, he lives there. Yeah, so what you been doing down there, my brother?
Man, I came over here in 2005. I was active duty Army. And I retired after 24 years. Mm. Yeah, 24 years, 6 months, and 13 days.
Wow.
And, I stayed over here, you know. Me and my wife had kids over here, and they loved it over here. They went to school, and after, you know, and I ended up, it's 5 years, turned it to 15 years, and I've just been over here. I was working for the government for a while, for about 5 years, but I was at the same time, I was doing music full-time also.
Wow.
But now all I do, I'm fully retired and I just do music for a living.
And man, I'll tell you one thing, boy. You haven't lost a beat. Man, you look good on that stage, boy. I'm like, look at this guy here.
Well, I'm going to tell you right now, bro. I got all of that confidence and, you know, charisma from being around, you know, the Body of Christ singers.
You know it.
Yeah,
yes, sir.
And the Nathaniel brothers, you know.
Yeah, man. We go a long way, man.
Wow. Oh, man, we go way back, brother.
Way back. Man, that's so proud to see you up there doing your thing, brother. Yeah, but I'm going to tell you one thing. I'm going to go ahead and take a break. And I'll be right. Hey, y'all, check out this video. This guy is on fire. We'll be right back. Just hold on.
In the park, strolling the summer days, imagining in my head and words from my heart, totally to the wind, even without being said. I don't wanna bore you with my trouble. There's something about your love that makes me weak and knocks me off my
enjoy that video. This is my guy, y'all. Man, this guy can blow. This boy can sing. And he can move. So what are you doing right now, man, since this pandemic going on?
Well, the last show I had, once everything happened with the pandemic, then it was a break in the music scene over here, you know, really shut down. Because prior to the scene, you know, I was touring everywhere. I'm in at least 5 different bands or productions. But the main one I'm with is called Sweet Soul Music Review. I've been with them for over 10 years. And, went on tour with them for like 5 weeks. And we do at least 60 shows a year. You know, and that's just with that one band. And then I play with other bands. You know, I got like 4 or 5 different bands. I sing every style. But my favorite, you know, my favorite is that gospel.
Yes,
you know, where my roots are, you know.
And
right now, I think my last show was October 23rd. It was the day after my mother passed away.
Wow.
And I had already committed to the show. And when I got there, they were like, Derrick, we didn't think you were going to come. I was like, why not? I said, I committed to it, you know. And then I said, I need this, you know, because, you know, it's like therapy for me.
Exactly.
And I went and did my show, and I haven't done one since October. But actually, yesterday, I did some studio work. Did some studio work for this famous German Schlager band, which is like German polka music.
Okay.
And went in the studio, did some backings for them, and I do jingles on the side, you know, for different companies. And hey, that's I stay busy. Plus, I'm a history major. I'm getting my master's degree right now. I'm almost finished. I have 2 more classes. I have a master's degree in history.
Wow.
So that's what I do all day.
Yeah. That's what's up. Man, that's sweet.
Stay busy.
I know that's right, man. Man, it's so glad talking to you. So how's the family?
Man, everybody's doing good, you know. It's been a minute since I've been home, like since 2017. But, you know, I go home a couple times a year. I talk to your brother Chris all the time.
Okay, yeah. Because what I was trying to do today, but it didn't work out for me. I was trying to get Larry, Chris, and Butch on the phone as well. And I was rushing getting home. My wife get off at 4, and I said I want to start a show at 5:30. I'm rushing. I was going to go back to Chris' house. We were going to do it over there. I got too much equipment to take over there just to do what I do.
Set up, yeah.
You know what I'm saying? But then I tried a phone call. It didn't work at all. I'm like, wow, still wouldn't work. Yeah, man. But I'm going to let them listen to another song of yours, man. Because I'm enjoying this. Hey, y'all, we be right back. Man, you on fire.
Come on, when I see you on the streets, my poor body gets weak. When you sing, bring
I got some honey, some chocolate chips, a kiss full of love for you. Ooh, yes, I got some honey, kiss for your lips. Yes, I got some honey, some chocolate chips, a kiss full of love for you. My life has been waiting for your love.
Welcome back, y'all, to the Past, Present, and Future Show. Yes, sir. Now, how y'all like that video? This guy is amazing. Look at some wonderful singers in that group as well. And at the end of this show, I don't want nobody to stop looking at this video. I'm going to show his whole concert, one segment of his whole concert. And y'all, let's stay tuned for that. But look, your inspiration, man. What's going on? Where do you get your inspiration from?
Oh, man, I've been singing since I was like three. My brother was a DJ, when I was younger. And I used to sleep by the speaker and listen to the music, all the old Motown stuff. And, Earth, Wind & Fire, but my favorite was Stevie Wonder.
Wow.
And that was before I got into gospel music. And then I fell in love with Commission, Marvin Winer, Daryl Coley, people like that. And Douglas Miller.
Oh yeah.
And then and it made me want to get into singing gospel music. And I ran into these brothers called the Nathaniel Brothers. It was Chris and Larry and Butch and Brother Rodney. You know what I'm saying?
So, yeah.
And then Brandon Taylor. We had us a group called Body of Christ Singers.
Yeah.
And we could be around. We used to have some good old times, and then nobody really knew, but Larry used to give me organ lessons.
Oh, wow.
Yeah. And wow. He basically was just, that was the first time I really started getting into playing music, trying to play some music because of Larry playing the organ. And then I said, he gave me a few lessons and stuff, taught me some chords, taught me basic theory. Oh, now wow. I read music, I can read all vocal parts and stuff, because I actually, from there, when I actually came in the Army in 1987, after a while, I ended up joining the Army band as a vocalist. Mm. And I did a vocalist thing for almost 12 years, man.
Yeah, sure. I was going to ask you how you got into it down there.
Oh, yeah. I was in the Army, the usual band, of course, over here in the United States Army, Europe Army Band. And
okay, but tell me this though. The selection of the music? Come on, dog. Y'all, Motown all the way. What's up with that?
Oh, yeah.
You sound with a Motown group, didn't you?
Yeah, I think so. One of the videos is the Motown. Well, actually, the group that I started in was called Sweet Soul Music Review. The guy, his name is Klaus Gossman, and he had this main singer he's been singing with for over 40, 50 years. His name is Jimmy James. Jimmy's like my dad, man. He's like, I call him Pop. Mm-hmm. And Jimmy has been his singer, his lead singer for all these years, and they had a party band. And then one of the friends of mine was in the band, and they invited me to the show, and they said, hey, you can sing. Let him come up. And then when I came up and did a Stevie Wonder song, and then as I was walking off stage, he grabbed my hand, shook, and he said, welcome to the Soul Finger family. Mm. And I've been in the group ever since. So throughout the years, he has actually, I think he has 10 different shows now. Mm. And I helped conceive some of these shows. He has one, it's called Sweet Soul Music Review. And that's where he do a combination of Stax Records and Motown. And then he has Classic Sounds of Motown.
Yeah.
And he has Queens of Soul. And then he has the Tina Turner Show.
Wow.
And then he has Sweet Soul Gospel. He has the Aretha Franklin Show. And one called Queens of Soul. I mean, he's constantly working, and I have my hands in almost every one of these shows. Yeah. And then every show that I'm not singing on, I do moderation. I introduce the acts and stuff. So,
you're out front, man, all the time.
It's easy.
Wow.
You know,
man.
I don't sound like I'm bragging or nothing, but it's just like I'm blessed to be able to do something that I'm passionate about. You
it's
know,
in
not
you.
Being passionate.
Yeah.
Yeah, it is.
It's in you. Yeah, cause let me tell you something, bro, that you probably didn't know. Man, when you left myself, I ain't thought the group can go on. I didn't think we could go on, dog, because you know, you lose one of your main lead singers, because you were one of the main lead singers. And you're like, man, we lost you, man. I'm like, man, you know what I'm saying? Because when you get so used to someone, you just continue want to sing with that person. But we worked it out, you know what I'm saying?
Yeah. Of course, man. Y'all still going strong. When I watch videos of y'all doing stuff, man, sometimes I feel so jealous because I'll be like, that's where I started. I need to be me standing there, Brandon on the other side.
Right, I know that's right.
You know, Chris in the middle singing the Ship of Zion or something.
Man. Hey, look, Ship of Zion, we sung that song a few years ago. My brother-in-law passed away, right? When he passed away, we sung it at his funeral. And it just came up in January on Facebook. I like, man. Yes.
Yeah, that was our song right there. We used to play at that Bishop Church.
Oh, Bishop Harris.
Bishop Harris. And they would have
Lily
all
Bridge.
Those different all them quartets would come over there on Sundays, man. And we would be over there all night long.
All night long. Yeah. And we got away from that scene.
Right.
Too much running around.
Yeah,
we got
yeah.
too old anyway.
We used to be in that van.
Yes, sir. The Body of Christ van.
Yeah,
right. Man, we used to have so much fun. Yeah, man. I want to thank you, man, for calling in and all the things that you're doing. Yeah, man. And just keep pushing, doing what you're doing. Man, let God keep blessing you.
Hey, man, just pray for me, man. I'm just trying to stay strong and figure this thing out day by day, you know, and praying that everybody stay safe. I thank God for, you know, social media platforms because it keeps us connected, you know.
Yeah.
You know, with our families and friends, and you guys more. Y'all were more than just my bandmates, man. Y'all like my brothers.
Exactly.
You know, that's like, and we are our brother's keepers. You know, I talked to Jimmy King the other day. I talked to Chris all the time. So, you know, y'all my family, man. So, and I never forget where I came from. I rep 313 every day, everywhere I go.
Wow.
So? It's all love.
I want people to know what time it is down there.
Right now, it's probably... It's 8 minutes after midnight. We're like six hours ahead.
Well, it's 6:03 here.
Yeah. So,
P.M.
You know, we're about 6. Yeah. It's 12 midnight here, so...
Well, you used to being up late doing concerts
all
night.
Yeah, I'm always up, man.
How many segments? How many sets y'all do?
Well, it depends on the band. Most of the bands don't do the two.
Okay.
Yeah, and it's good money. It's really good. The pay is really good. The German people love us. You know, and there's some really good musicians here, so it makes you better as a singer. And then it's if the way the scene is set over here, if you do more than what they contract you for, then they pay you extra. So
appreciation.
It's really lucrative. Oh yeah, they really
appreciate.
Do.
And so
and I've been doing it now for a while, so I'm
so most of the music, you bring to the table.
Well, I pick all of my songs.
Okay.
And, you know, if it's something I want to do. Like, when I do my own personal shows where I'm the only one singing, I do different things. But I sing in different groups, jazz bands, big bands. And then we travel. I've been all over Switzerland, the Netherlands, Norway, been to Cairo, Egypt, been to Italy, on tour in Italy. I've been all over Germany. I've been to it's Mallorca, everywhere, man. I've been all over Europe.
And the good thing about it, the music, man, the sound ain't cheap. Oh my God.
Sure.
My wife,
no,
look.
It's quality.
Let me tell you something. On my way home today, I plugged my phone in. Like I said, I download you know, a couple of y'all things that you singing.
Right.
And my wife, I plug it in. She listened to it. She gets to dancing. I say, look, this my homie. She said, right. I thought it was the radio. I said, no, that sound is, I mean, professional. I like, wow.
Well, they spend like money. They spend money on their sound man because they care about what they sound like.
Yeah.
They don't because it makes no sense to have great singers and then crappy sound because it'll make it sound like the singers are not good. So they spend money. Like the guy that been in the group for 10 years, he owns his own sound crew.
Wow.
So everywhere he goes, he uses the same sound people, so you get the same quality. You know,
wow, so. That's good.
And he has like a 20 piece. He got a 22 piece. He got about 12 musicians, and sometimes the most he'll have is like he'll have 11 singers.
Wow, yeah. How can I be down?
Hey man, all you gotta do is get a passport and come on over here, man.
It's hard as hell
now. As soon as the world open back up, you get a passport, come over here, and wow. I got you. For real, I know a few bands that are looking for, you know, good singers, man, and you know, and everybody in your family would make some money over here.
Yeah, I would love. Cause I wanted my son to travel to Germany as well, he's a great singer as well, and but he live in Minnesota right now.
Yeah. Okay, it's easy to make it over here because, you know, they really appreciate, you know, black artists. Really, because yeah, they really appreciate us and they pay us what we worth.
Wow.
And they appreciate the music. They respect the, you know, the culture and everything of black music. And then we don't just do cover stuff. You know, I got friends over here putting out albums, man. And these people, you know, they're the German, you know, public. They really supporting them and everything. And we all support each other.
Wow.
So. Yeah. This,
man, I can't wait to hear something else from you. When you get your jingles out, I want to hear them jingles.
Oh yeah, they haven't sent them to me now. So I went in a couple of times. Did some things, and they just sent me the notification saying they're gonna start releasing them this month. And the one I did yesterday, you know, we just finished it yesterday. So it's nothing. I ain't heard nothing about it yet, but I got a few things under the belt coming up. And also, I've played with these bands, and we've, you know, I've recorded albums and
wow,
with all of these guys. And I have this one band that I'm with. It's called Soul Diamonds.
Yeah, and that's what I'm talking about. Soul Diamonds.
Yeah.
Oh my God.
Yeah.
Now that's the band I'm talking about.
Yeah.
Everybody can blow.
Yeah. That's Charles Simmons. Fola Dada and my homegirl Eva Leticia from the Bronx, New York, the
wow.
Hispanic girl. Yeah, and the band is nice.
So she came down there just for music, or how did that happen?
Man, it's so many Americans over here that's just full time musicians, bro. And one of the reasons is because they you know, the money we make over here, they will never pay us in the States because there's so much competition and they feel like they don't have to.
Wow.
You know, if you got a good, great singer who says, well, I want you to pay me this, they'd be like, why? And I got somebody who can sing just as well as you, or maybe not as well as you, but they so anxious, they'll cutthroat you.
Yep.
You know, just give a round number, you know. So if somebody says, you offer you $100.
I definitely say that at Motor City Casino, they had a this bar called a Dramatic Bar. They had live entertainment. They were paying them people $100 for three shows a piece. Three shows.
You know, let me tell you, I've been on gigs where I've made $2,000 for like maybe 2 hours worth of work.
See?
And I wasn't on stage the whole time.
Wow.
Yeah, wow. It's really lucrative here. And then if you're a black singer, oh, they love it. The whole band will be German. You see your next group.
Yes.
Me and Fuller and Charles are the only black people in the band.
Wow. And And they be slapping too. And I didn't know they had that talent down there. I ain't gonna lie to you.
Oh yeah, man, music is universal. So you know, man, these guys go to school, bro.
Wow.
They and the bass player, him and the drummer are the leaders of the band. And they wrote all the arrangements. They made did all the horn parts, everything.
And you one know, thing I noticed did, too, y'all a live band.
Live band. That's all they do over here.
Real
That's
horns.
They don't do no playback. They don't do no playbacks.
I know
if you
that's
do a
right.
playback gig, it's because it's maybe a wedding reception or something. But other than that, live band. But if you do anything you do with the small, you know how it is, the smaller the setup, the more money you make. So you can, more money you can charge. And me, you know, most of those singers are freelance artists.
Wow.
We're not signing nobody's, you know, labels. We're not signing nobody's groups. So
makes
that's why
sense.
I say I sing in five different groups. I manage my own self. I don't have no management. You know, my wife don't do. I manage my own calendar because I know can't nobody manage me better than me because I know what I want, how I want it, how much I want to get paid, and what I will do. And you know,
well,
and
when
then
this stuff-
that way, when I get there to the gig, I'm happy because I've handled all the business, so I don't have to worry about. You know, now it's about the music.
Well, I'll tell you what. When all this stuff over with, I'm going to come down there. You're going to manage me.
Nah. Yeah, I'm telling you, bro. You have enough knowledge. All I'm going to do is do like... I'm going to do you like they did me. And like I do a lot of my friends who come over here to do music. Because I've had a few friends that just showed up. And they come over on gospel tours during the Christmas time. Because that's mainly when the Germans have gospels. They feel... The winter, Christmas time is gospel time. But, you know, the way we was raised, every day is gospel time.
Exactly.
You know? So they come over on a gospel tour and love it, and they end up staying.
Wow.
I have friends been here anywhere from 15 to 25, 30 years.
Wow.
Speaking fluent German and from Mississippi somewhere, you know, because they come over here and they see the culture and... And they see how easy it is to, you can come over here and set up house, survive, you know, get cars and a place to live and make money and, you know.
Yeah, my brother-in-law never thought about coming up here. He visits twice a year, that's it.
He lives in Germany.
Yep. He had a German wife. He have two kids and he have one grandkid now. Yeah.
Okay, yay. Hey, man, I'm telling you. You know, when my mother was alive, she asked me one time, she said, so, you know, my mom always supported anything I did. And she didn't care because she said, you know, I taught you, you know, right from wrong, so I ain't worried about you. So she said, are you ever planning on coming home? And I said, Mom, I love my family. I love to visit. I come home twice a year in April and October, but, you know, right now, you know, I'm doing what I need to do for me and mine right here. You know, it's just nothing against my city. I love my city. I really enjoy it. You know, and all of my kids, none of my kids live there anymore. They all grown. And my oldest is 35. My youngest is 21. And they all live in four different states. So.
Wow. Yeah. Our kids the same age.
Yeah.
I got two of them, two daughters. They're 36. Yep. Wow. That's what's up, man.
Yeah. My son is 35. My youngest daughter. I got three daughters and a son. DJ is 35. Jasmine is 31. Michaela is 24. And the baby girl is in college in California. She's 21.
Wow. That's good for you, man. You doing your thing.
Man, life is blessed. Life is blessed, man. I'm good.
Yes, sir.
Life is good.
Yeah, man. I really enjoyed this interview, man. Really enjoyed.
Oh yeah, brother. So have I, man. It's good to to hear from you again. You know, I see you all the time on Facebook and be checking out everything you good. You're doing your thing, man.
Yeah, I have a studio opening up pretty soon. Hopefully next month. And live studio audience and stuff like that. And also gonna have live entertainment. stuff like, you know, interview them pretty, after they get to performing. Pretty good.
Right.
Yeah.
Okay. Gonna be like Black Johnny Carson or somebody.
That's right.
That's right. Do it, man. Do it.
Yeah, I'm trying to do something. Yeah. I'm gonna get, I can get anybody on my show. I'll get what's his name was on there? He got fired because he had what that guy from National Airline? Farrakhan.
Mm-hmm.
I'm gonna get Donald Trump.
Wow. Hey.
Oh man. Yes, sir. Man, thanks for calling in, man. I'm gonna let you go ahead and get you some sleep. Man, I appreciate you.
Brother.
I love you, man.
I love you, sir. Too, bro.
And you stay safe out there, all right, my man?
Always, always.
And remember, everyone, please don't hang up. I mean, stop looking at this video because I want y'all to see this full concert of this guy here. Thanks a lot, Derrick, for calling, brother.
No problem, Rodney. I'll holler at you later, brother.
All right, thank you.
Thanks for having me.
All right, for sure. Yes, y'all, this has been another Past, Present, and Future show where God is the same yesterday and today and forever. Peace. Love y'all.
Come on. nicht aus Berlin kommen. Du musst nicht aus Frankfurt sein. Du musst nicht aus Haarheim kommen. Mir egal, wo du her bist, du bist mein. Und ich lieb dich so sehr, wie keine andere vor dir. Und keine andere nach dir. Du bist hier und ich weiß, wir zwei gehören zusammen wie Glied. L.O.B.S. und die andere Team. Ich weiß genau, wo sie gerade steht. L.O.B.S. ist da und ich weiß, dass sie abgeht. Oh, sie liebt mich und ich lieb sie. So muss es sein und ich bin ein MC. Doch heute nur für sie und sie und sie, sie. Yes, so muss es sein und ich hab's, ich lieb sie. Und ich hab's alle lieb. Und ich weiß, ihr seid gut drauf. Ey, Stuttgart, sei mal laut. Oh ja, sie sind so laut wie nie. Hör mir gut zu, ja, es ist eine krasse MC. Es ist der L.O.B.S. und ich hör nicht auf den Flexen. Mit dem wunderbaren Horn-Section. Wir lieben es auch.
The best and present, the past.